Hello student, welcome to all of you. In this lecture, we study second type of network model, that is TCP/IP model. And topic discussed will be layers in TCP/IP architecture and protocol suite of TCP/IP model. So let's start. TCP/IP reference model. TCP/IP is acronym of Transmission Control Protocol and Internet Protocol. The OSI reference model was the first communication model and was termed as general purpose model because of its ability to fit in any type of network but without fitting the protocols in. Due to its inability to fit protocol, TCP/IP reference model, which is commonly known as internet model, was developed in year 1983 by Department of Defense Project Research Agency as a part of research project of network interconnection to connect remote machines. These were used earlier by ARPANET and then it is being used by Internet. ARPANET means the Advanced Research Project Agency Network. It was the first wide area packet switching network with distributed control and one of the first network to implement TCP/IP protocol suite. The features that stood out during the research which led to making TCP/IP reference model were: first one, it supports for flexible architecture, means adding more machine to network was easy. The network was robust and the connections remain intact until the source and destination machines were functioning. This will be the architecture of both. Internet model comprises only 4 layers as compared to 7 layers of OSI model. These 4 layers are generated by combining the layer of OSI model internally so that protocols can be implemented. This layer have fixed position 2 and their position cannot be altered. When we see the diagram, it clearly says that application, presentation and session layer of OSI model are combined in TCP model in single layer, that is application layer. Transport layer of OSI model corresponds to transport layer in TCP/IP model. Then network layer is known as internet layer in TCP/IP model. And last two, that is data link layer and physical layer, are combined into single one, that is network interface model. In this way, there is only 4 layers in TCP/IP model. So we see the functioning of each one by one and protocol related with each layer of TCP/IP model in detail in next topics. So first one, that is network access layer. It is the lowest layer of TCP/IP model. The network access layer of TCP/IP reference model is also known as host-to-host or host-to-network layer, as it is responsible for performing role of physical layer along with the functions of data link layer of ISO/OSI reference model. It looks out for hardware addressing and the protocol present in this layer allow for physical transmission of data. Data in the form of bit received in network access layer are connected in the form of data packet to internet layer. Host to network layer defines the details how data is physically sent through the network, including how bits are electrically or optically signaled by hardware devices. The functions carried out by this layer are encapsulating the IP datagram into frame transmitted by network and mapping of IP address into physical address. The protocol used by this layer are Ethernet, Token Ring, FDDI, X.25 and Frame Relay. Second layer, that is Internet layer. It is a second layer of TCP/IP model, also known as a network layer, which pack data into data packet known as IP datagrams, which contain source and destination address used to forward datagram between host and across the network. So it is responsible for routing of IP datagram. to send the packet from any network and they arrive at the destination irrespective of the route they take. It allows hosts to insert packet into any network and have them to deliver independently to the destination. Protocols used at this layer are IP, that is Internet Protocol, ICMP, ARP, RARP, IGMP, etc. We discuss this all protocol in short in next topic. The first and very important protocol at this layer is IP protocol, which stands for Internet Protocol, and it is responsible for delivering packet from source host to destination host by looking at the IP address in packet header. It is unreliable connectionless protocol used by TCP/IP model at internet layer. This protocol is used for data transmission. This protocol doesn't do error checking or tracking of data. Thus, we cannot be sure that the data is actually reach its destination. This is why it is also known as best effort delivery service, which means this protocol tries its best to send data to its destination, but doesn't take any guarantee. This protocol transmits the data in form of small packet known as datagram. Each of these datagram are transmitted separately, thus they can take different route and sometime duplicate datagram can be reached to destination. Also, they are reached in no particular order at the destination. There are some responsibilities of this protocol. First responsibility is IP addressing. This protocol implements logical host addresses known as IP addresses. The IP addresses are used by internet and higher layer to identify device and to provide inter-network routing. Second responsibility is host-to-host communication, which determines the path through which data is to be transmitted. Then, data encapsulation and formatting are also handled by IP protocol. An IP protocol accepts data from transport layer protocol. An IP protocol ensures that data is sent and received securely. It encapsulates the data into message known as IP datagram. Then, fragmentation and reassembly. The limit imposed on the size of IP datagram by data link layer protocol is known as maximum transmission unit. If the size of IP datagram is greater than maximum transmission unit, then IP protocol splits the datagram into smaller unit, so they can travel over a local network. Fragmentation can be done by sender or intermediate router. At the receiver side, all the fragments are reassembled to form an original message. Then last responsibilities of this protocol is routing. When IP datagram is sent over the same local network, then it is known as a direct delivery. When source and destination are on distant network, then the IP datagram is sent indirectly. This can be accomplished by routing the IP datagram through various devices such as router. There are two versions of IP protocol, that is IPv4 and IPv6. IPv4 is one that most of the websites are using currently, but IPv6 is growing as the number of IPv4 addresses are limited in number when compared to number of users. Then second protocol, that is ICMP, which stands for Internet Control Message Protocol. It is encapsulated within IP datagram and is responsible for providing host with information about network problem. ICMP protocol sends the datagram problem back to sender. It is used for query and error reporting messages. The datagram travels from router to router until it reaches its destination. If router is unable to route the data because of some unusual condition such as disabled link, a device is on fire, or network congestion, then ICMP protocol is used to inform sender that the datagram is undeliverable. The ICMP protocol mainly uses two terms, first one ICMP test and second one ICMP reply. ICMP test is used to test whether the destination is reachable or not, whereas ICMP reply is used to check whether a destination device is responding or not. The core responsibility of ICMP protocol is to report the problem, not correct them. The responsibility of correction lies with the sender. ICMP can send message only to source but not to intermediate routers, because IP datagram carries the address of source and destination but not of the router that it is passed to. Then next protocol, ARP, that is, it stands for address resolution protocol. Its job is to find hardware address or physical address of a host from known IP address. In network, each device is known by its physical address, usually imprinted on network interface card. There are two terms that are mainly associated with ARP protocol, that is ARP request and ARP reply. When sender want to know the physical address of the device, it broadcasts the ARP request to the network. When ARP device attached to network will accept ARP request and process the request, but only recipient recognize the IP address and sends back its physical address in the form of ARP reply. The recipient adds physical address both to its cache memory and to datagram header. ARP has several types like reverse ARP, proxy ARP, inverse ARP and so on. Next protocol, that is IGMP, means Internet Group Message Protocol, which is used for simultaneous transmission of a message to group of recipient. Third layer of TCP/IP model is transport layer. The transport layer provides the reliability, flow control and correction of data which is being sent over the network. It is responsible for end-to-end communication and error-free delivery of data from source to destination. It corresponds to transport layer of OSI model. Purpose of this layer is to permit device on the source and destination host to carry on conversation. It defines level of service and status of connection used when transporting data. It shields the upper layer application from the complexities of data. The two main protocol used by this layer is TCP and UDP that we will discuss. So first important protocol at transport layer is transmission control protocol. It is reliable connection oriented protocol. It is known as to provide reliable and error-free communication between end system. A connection is established between peer entities prior to transmission, means it creates the virtual circuit between sender and receiver, and it is active for the duration of data transmission. TCP is reliable protocol as it detects the error and retransmits the damaged frame. Therefore, it ensures all segment must be received and acknowledged before transmission is considered to be completed and a virtual circuit is discarded. It performs sequencing and segmentation of data. At the sending end, TCP divides whole message into smaller unit known as segment, and each segment contains a sequence number which is required for reordering the frame to form original message at receiver side. At the receiving end, TCP collects all segment and reorders them according to sequence number. It also has acknowledgement features and controls the flow of data through flow control mechanism. It is very effective but has lot of overhead due to such features. Increased overhead lead to increased cost. Next protocol, that is user datagram protocol. It is go-to protocol, means if your application does not require reliable transport, It is very cost-effective protocol. It is message-oriented protocol that provides simple, unreliable, connectionless, unacknowledgement service. It is suitable for applications that do not require TCP sequencing, error control, or flow control. It is used for transmitting small amount of data, where speed of delivery is more important than accuracy of delivery. It is unreliable protocol as it discovered the error but not specify the error. User datagram protocol, that is UDP, only discovers the error. UDP does not specify which packet is lost. UDP contains only checksum. It does not contain any ID of data segment. Then next protocol, that is Stream Control Transmission Protocol, means SCTP. It combines the features of both, means TCP and UDP. It is message oriented like UDP, which providing reliable connection oriented service like TCP. It is used for telephony over the internet. Then next layer, that is application layer. The application layer is highest abstraction layer of TCP/IP model that provides the interface and protocol needed by the user. It combines the functionality of session layer, presentation layer, and application layer of OSI model. It provides different services such as manipulation of information in several ways, retransferring the files of information, distributing the result, etc. The functions of application layer are, it facilitates the user to use the service of network. It is used to develop network-based application. It provides user services like user login, naming network devices, formatting messages and emails, transfer of file, etc. It is also concerned with error handling and recovery of message as a whole. The functions such as login or password checking are also performed by application layer. The protocol used by this layer are Telnet, FTP, SMTP, DNS, HTTP, etc. So first protocol, that is HTTP and HTTPS. HTTP stands for Hypertext Transfer Protocol. It is used by World Wide Web to manage communication between web browsers and servers. HTTPS stands for HTTP Secure. It is combination of HTTP with Secure Socket Layer. It is efficient in cases where the browser need to fill out form, sign in, authenticate and carry out bank transaction. Second protocol at this layer is SSH, which stands for Secure Shell. It is terminal emulation software similar to Telnet. The reason SSH is more preferred because of its ability to maintain the encrypted connection. It sets up secure session over TCP/IP connection. Then Telnet, which is a two-way communication protocol, allows connecting to remote machine and run application on it. It is an abbreviation for terminal network. It establishes a connection between local computer and remote computer in such a way that local terminal appears to be terminal at remote system. The next, FTP, means file transfer protocol. It is a protocol that allows file transfer among computer user connected over a network. It is reliable, simple, and efficient. It is a client-server-based protocol for transfer of files between client and server over a network. Simple Mail Transfer Protocol, that is SMTP. It is a protocol which is used to transport electronic mail between source and destination, directed via route. Domain Name Server, which resolves an IP address into textual address for host connected over a network. It is a naming system for device in network. It provides service for translating domain name to IP address. Next, SNMP, which stands for Simple Network Management Protocol. It is a framework used for managing, monitoring the network and for organizing information about the network device on the internet by using TCP/IP protocol suite. This table represents protocol of each layer at TCP/IP, known as TCP/IP protocol suite. It was developed prior to OSI model, hence it do not exactly match those in OSI model. TCP/IP is hierarchical protocol made up of interactive model with specific functionality. These models are interdependent. Merits of TCP/IP model. It operated independently of operating system. It is scalable. Client server architecture will be handled using TCP/IP model. It supports a number of routing protocol. It can be used to establish a connection between two computers. Demerits. In this, transport layer does not guarantee about delivery of packet. The model cannot be used in any other application. In this, replacing protocol is not easy task. It has not clearly separated its services, interface and protocol like ISO/OSI reference model. Next, hybrid model. This diagram represents hybrid model. In the real world, we use the mix of both, that is OSI model and TCP/IP model, called hybrid model. In the hybrid model, the application layer is combination of layer 7, 6 and 5 of OSI model. The remaining layer, that is 1, 2, 3 and 4, is same as OSI model. Means here application layer is combination of application, session and presentation layer of OSI model, and all other layer are as it is. Thank you.